my fellow extraordinary Americans. My name is Cosmos, and this is Extraordinary America. What is Extraordinary America about? Extraordinary America is about the abolition of financial slavery. It is about the financial freedom of the 99%. It is also about bringing America to a state of empathy instead of narcissism, right? Why? This is because right now, most Americans are under a state of financial slavery. They're living from one paycheck to another, and they're barely able to make ends meet. And with the loss of jobs due to the coronavirus pandemic, many of them are having a hard time paying the bills, right? Moreover, over a long period of time, we've been suffering from something called stagflation, where stagflation is a combination of stagnant wages combined with inflation, right? Inflation is where money has been printed at a large amount, but which is backed by nothing, and that devalues every individual dollar over a period of time. So which means that if you go to the grocery store, right, every time you go to buy a certain amount of goods in the grocery store, like milk or whatever, it'll cost more and more over a period of time. Now combine that with the fact that you have stagnant wages, right, due to outsourcing of jobs, and also due to a number of other factors, where you have a large number of people competing for the same amount of jobs, and therefore companies are able to give you are able to give a certain amount of income and not increase it over a period of time, right? Due to abundance of labor, what you get is a stagflation, which reduces your ability to buy enough goods and services, and that actually reduces your ability to be financially free. To add to that thing is the fact that if you have debt, right, in order to maintain your lifestyle, which is spend now and pay later, what happens is that now you are forced to do a job in order to keep paying off the debt, and combine with the fact that there's stagnant wages and prices keep rising means that you are going under more and more financial slavery. And the last point is that right now we're going to go through an economic depression, or we already are in an economic depression, but in the very near future, that is going to be replaced with a hyperinflation, because what the banks and the government have done is that they have printed large amounts of money into the system, which is backed by nothing. Large amounts of fiat money. And what happens is that once the economy starts getting better and people start spending money again and the velocity of money increases, what will happen is that there'll be a massive rise in prices to make up for all the additional money in the system. And because of the fact that our wages will not keep up with inflation, most people are going to go into dire poverty, and that is the equivalent of financial slavery. Moreover, in our country, what we are seeing is an increased state of narcissism, right, on a national level. And what we want is more of empathy, because you cannot solve problems through a feeling of us versus them. You can only solve problems to a state of cooperation and coordination, and that takes empathy. So what is Extraordinary America about? Extraordinary America is about the abolition of financial slavery. It is about the financial freedom of the 99%. We do not work for money. We make money work for us, right? And it's also about bringing empathy into America as well. And how is this to be done on the financial front? It is to be done in the short term by saving your existing money into scarcity-based tangible assets such as gold, silver, or cryptocurrencies, which will protect you from the devaluation and hyperinflation of the dollar or fiat money. And in the long term, this is to be done by, number one, transformation of the 99% into entrepreneurs and investors on the light side. Number two, the creation of spiritual economic institutions led by Jedipreneurs that will create a universal basic income for people in their region, and also provide the five essentials of food, housing, healthcare, education, and clothes, right? And also help people towards attaining financial freedom. Why? Because everybody is part of one giant cosmic family of the one father who is the creator of the universe. And what the Jedipreneurs do is that they act instead of the father, who is the creator of the universe and who is the ultimate one percenter on the light side, right? Think about all the families who are one percenters, where the father and mother is an entrepreneur, or just the father or just the mother is an entrepreneur. They teach their children how to become financially free, but they also give them a safety zone from where to begin so that they do not come, they do not go from a dire place of poverty, and they're allowed, they can do business with relative success. That's the same way Jedipreneurs will treat the people in this planet as members of one family, because we are members of one family. And the third thing is the replacement of the debt-based fiat monetary system, not with the gold standard or with a crypto standard or any other standard, but with the American dream standard or the humanity upliftment standard. Because what is money? Money is a store of value. It is a medium of exchange for value, and it is a unit of account for value. And what is the ultimate value? What does the father of the universe find valuable? And that is the upliftment of humanity. It is an uplifted humanity, and is not gold, silver, or cryptocurrencies. We as humans for thousands of years have been materialistic. But now the time has come to realize that the real value is an uplifted human being. An uplifted human being with all the basic essentials, with civil rights, and the most important thing, and that is part of upliftment, is freedom. So in today's video, right, I want to talk briefly about the subtle differences, or in some case crude differences, between the law of one on one side and the law of ego on the other side. Because in the previous video, we're talking about two roads and two Americas, right? And what is law of one in essence, and what is law of ego? On one side, you have the light side, right? The law of oneness, of interconnectedness, of knowing that we are all part of each other, we are all interconnected, right? And if something bad happens to somebody else, eventually it is going to cause us harm in the long run, right? Because there's only one consciousness which permeates everything, and we are all part of each other, right? Because we all come from one place, and we all come from one zone, to speak, right? It is about, the law of one is about freedom. It is about upliftment. It is about compassion and empathy, right? Because when you have that state of oneness, you naturally start to have a state of empathy for everybody. When you have a state of love that permeates you, you have a state of empathy and understanding, and you become a humanist, and you have a humanistic approach towards things. The law of one is also about understanding that there is only one consciousness, or one creator of the universe that is out there, right? You could look at it in a very spiritual term, or you can look at it in a scientific term and see that there's only one substance that permeates all of us. And if you're looking at it in a personal way, you realize that there's only one Father that's permeating all of us, and that we are all connected to Him, and therefore we are all connected to each other. And that's where love and compassion and all the higher emotions come from. And then on the other side, you have the law of ego, which is about the law of separateness. It's about the law of looking outside, right? It's all about control and domination. It's about degradation. It's about humiliation. It's about a zero-sum game, where basically, in order for me to succeed, somebody else has to lose. It is a law of competition, and it is a law of fighting for survival. It's a law of scarcity, right? And it's a law of self-aggrandizement and selfishness at the expense of others. Whereas the law of one is about being in harmony and raising all the ships. The law of ego is about putting yourself up and bringing everybody down, right? Which is what right now this nation is going through, right? Most of us have reached a stage where we are following the law of ego instead of the law of oneness. Or in a more broader term, that is what the national state of affairs has become, where everybody is thinking in law of ego terms. They're thinking in terms of group identity instead of realizing that we are all part of each other. The real enemy is not black, white, brown, yellow, orange, or gender, or races, or ethnicity, or whatever it is. The real difference is between those that choose the law of oneness and those that choose the law of ego or separation. Those that choose selfishness on this hand and those that choose upliftment on the other. Those that realize that they're interconnected and those that think that they're separate and superior to the rest of the other people by a certain amount, right? There is empathy and then there's narcissism. There's good and then there's a sense of evil. I mean, what is evil essentially? Evil is a sense of lack of empathy or compassion and a sense of wanting to hurt others or take away from them, right? Whereas goodness is all about giving and providing value and about uplifting them and loving them and being there for them, right? And so basically that is the only two difference, right? You could have different groups. You could have black or white or whatever it is, and you realize that, or you could have different ethnicities, different nationalities, right? And you could realize that in every nationality, there are those that follow the law of oneness inherently. They're just generally, they're empathetic, and then they are there for each other. And then there are those that separate themselves and divide as a result, right? Anything, right? It's not about which ethnicity or race or gender or whatever it is, or whatever classification you want to put, rich or poor. It's about those that follow the law of one and those that follow the law of ego. And there can be no reconciliation between the two. Those that follow the path of empathy, those that follow the law of narcissism, those that follow the path of knowing that we're all there for each other, and that we're all interconnected, and those that follow the path of, oh, I'm better than these people, superiority, and then dominance and control. And let me be realistic, right? We all have a sense of law of oneness and a sense of law of egotism in all of us, right? To various degrees. Some people, it's 30%, 70%. Other people, 40%, 60%, 50-50, 60-40, 70-30, right? There's different ratios. There's people that are 80% or 90% or higher. The people that are 80% or 90% or higher on both extremes. And then there's the 50 shades of gray in between, right? Metaphorically, there's a 50 shades of gray, or what you can say, the 50 shades of America, or the 50 shades of Russia or China or India or whatever nation you want to put it, or anything else, right? You have people with different propensities, right? And basically there is good inside of us, and then there's evil inside of us. There's empathy inside of us, and there's narcissism inside of us. And it is our choice to choose which path we're going to follow. Because we mistakenly believe that by choosing the path of the law of ego, that we're going to attain happiness. But that happiness might be short-lived, and it leads to greater misery and suffering, right? But we don't realize that, right? But it is for us to realize which choice to follow. And if we do choose the law of empathy, or we do choose the path of oneness, then that's where actual change happens. But in order for that to happen, we have to start within ourselves, right? We got to change ourselves. And then from there, we create a ripple effect, and we start to make a difference, right? We start to become a shining light, no matter how impossible the odds are. Yes, there is the light and there is the darkness. And right now, the darkness is overwhelming across the entire world. But then we are the light. But only if we choose that within us, we're going to choose the law of oneness. And there's more to these two philosophies, right? But that's all I have to say for now. And if you like what we're talking about, please do subscribe to this channel. And all I have to say is bye for now. Take care.